चलो सबका रोल है अभी
रोलिंग
ओके आदित्य जी सबसे पहले तो आप सभी टीम को ममास बॉय के लिए कांग्रेचुलेशन ये शॉर्ट फिल्म है जहाँ तक अभी तक हमें बताया गया लेकिन ये किस शॉर्ट फिल्म के बारे में आप लोग कुछ बताएं कि कैसी होगी ये फिल्म
लार्ज शॉर्ट फिल्म
लार्ज शॉर्ट
अच्छा आई थिंक आई लेट अक्षर टॉक
गो फॉर इट
नो 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 यू यू कम ऑन
शॉर्ट फिल्म है जहाँ तक ये सही है कि शॉर्ट फिल्म है जितनी होनी चाहिए उतनी शॉर्ट नहीं है और जितनी थी उतनी नहीं है कट कटा के अभी करीब 13 मिनट 15 मिनट की फिल्म है और ये कहानी मैं जब बचपन में बड़ा हो रहा था अमर चित्र का था और इस तरह की कहानियाँ पढ़ पढ़ के तो मुझे हमेशा ख्याल आता था महाभारत से there's a story in the महाभारत about कि अर्जुन गया द्रौपदी का हाथ जीत के आया उसने मछली की आँख में तीर मारा और द्रौपदी को लेके घर आया और जब वो घर आया वापस तो उसकी माँ ने बोला जो भी लेके आए हो बेटा अपने भाइयों में बांट लो और उन्होंने बांट लिए मुझे हमेशा ये खलता था कि ऐसे कैसे हो सकता है कि आदमी गया लड़ मर के ये सब कर कर आके बीवी जीत के लाया हाँ सेंटर में इधर देखो ठीक है बीवी जीत के लाया घर आया वापस और उसकी माँ ने कहा बांट लो और उसने बांट लिया इसमें गड़बड़ है कुछ तो अगर कहानी ऐसी नहीं हुई होती थोड़ा उसमें बदलाव होता तो क्या कहानी निकल के आती तो ये मामाज बॉयज इसके बारे में ये वो कहानी इट्स अ अल्टरनेट रियलिटी टू व्हाट माइट हैव हैपेंड
ओके अच्छा तो नॉट ब्राउन इज जीरो डाउन द स्टार कास्ट ऑफ द फिल्म
आई हैड अ विश लिस्ट ऑफ पीपल आई वांटेड टू वर्क विद या आई
एम सो सॉरी
आई फील लाइक आई एम क्रॉस आईड राइट लुकिंग लंदन टॉकिंग टू So I had a wish list of people I wanted to work with, and I was really fortunate that as we started casting, Panchmi Ghavri, who was our casting director, who was fantastic. We sat and we talked about it, and she said, "I'm going to just go with your wish list. I'm going to start and ask the people you really want, and if you get them, fantastic." So it's really up to her because she made it happen. Because my usual nervousness is, "Oh, nahi hoga, mana kar denge, ye hoga, wo sab." So she was fearless. She said, "I'm going to ask." And we were really fortunate that the people we asked, they all came on board.
Okay, Aditi, what was your first reaction the moment the makers of this film approached you?
She was horrified.
No, I think the moment I heard that Akshat was directing it and had written it, I was very interested to know what it was because I've seen his earlier work and have seen it multiple times and driven my friends mad because I've gone to the theater multiple times to watch that film, Delhi Belly, and every time I've watched it, I've cracked my sides laughing. Literally, I was like the noisiest person in the theater. So I was like, I have to work with this person. And again, I think sab log Mahabharat ki kahani padke bade hue hain. Aur meri nani ne in fact likhi hai ek children's Mahabharat. So it has been a very, very important part of my childhood, that story. So when I read this, it was a totally, like, it was a chatpata spin on the story. And it made Draupadi a very spunky person because, you know, we see her as a very a strong, sort of courageous woman, actually, who takes on whatever's thrown at her, she takes it on and she, like, she's amazing. But in this, there's this chatpata thing where she's actually playing, like, it's fun. It's got a fun vibe. And I liked how he characterized it and I loved how he put a spin on all the characters. I also, this whole thing ki ek gen next ka Mahabharat, jin sabke paas cell phones hai, jo bhi aap dekhenge film mein, meko actually wo padke bahut maza aaya. And I feel that the script is actually so important to what we're making. And to make a story like this into something so fun, I wanted to be a part of it. It's just fun. It was, I don't think one can intellectualize it or talk too much about it. It was just fun. And it was really, really funny. I had to stop myself from laughing on set constantly. I think I gave them a really hard time because I had to try and keep a straight face. It was very hard for me to do that.
Okay, the way you said, the way, you know, Akshat narrated it, it looked more female-oriented film. Do you think that the title justifies with this, Mama's Boys, to both of you?
Well, it is a female-oriented film, but the whole point is that these boys, so the female orientation is the mother, Kunti, and then Draupadi, the daughter-in-law who's coming into the house. And the boys are really It's called Mama's Boys because they get pushed around by their mother. So we think of these, of the Pandavas as warriors, but they really are these really quiet little boys who do what their mother tells them. So that's really what that title is about.
Do you think it's justified?
Yeah, I mean, I like the spin on it because actually, aap ek kahani alag alag nazariye se dekh sakte hain. And if you actually delve deeper into it, what he's saying is absolutely right. So big grown-up warriors, one of them goes and wins a girl. That itself I find a bit ridiculous. But anyway, chalo, that happened. He wins this girl. And then the mother, without looking at what he has, says, ki bant lo. And they're like, okay, yes, sir, three bags full, sir. That's what, I mean, that it's just, it's really funny. And to I think, make light of it is what I think is fun. And I think should have been done, so it's been done now. It's great. And I think, you know, sometimes we all tend to take ourselves too seriously. It's fun, especially with mythology and all. But I think even the people in those stories were half the time laughing at themselves. So I think we should also learn to do that because it just makes life a whole lot better. And you're just laughing more. I think it's good to laugh.
What was the most challenging part while working on this project?
What was the most challenging part? I think to keep a serious face. I'm not going to lie and say that, oh, this role, I spent 10 days working for it. It wasn't that. It was just trying to keep a serious face. It was really hard.
Okay, your working experience with Neena Gupta, you know.
Amazing. She was the cause of my laughter. She was saying everything with a deadpan face and the most hilarious dialogues. And she's an incredible actor. Ek toh, like, her lines, the way she mugs her lines was insane. I don't know how she was doing it because she was just saying, acha fir se bolo, and she would hear it once or twice and ha, ready, and she would do it. But her pauses and the way that she would say her lines, they didn't seem like dialogues. They just seemed like she was talking to somebody, and she was this Punjabi mother talking to her sons, and it was really funny, or talking to her daughter-in-law. It was really hilarious.
And I died
laughing. And you know, I've seen some of her movies. I've seen a retrospective of Shyam Benegal Saab's, and I've seen her in those movies and all, but you see it firsthand, like when you're on set, and it's really amazing. She's an insane actor.
And Aditi, and you, ki ye film online on air hone wali hai, to uske liye aap log kitne excited hain is film ko lekar?
Film ban ke nikal jaye, that's a huge, huge thing. So I mean, I don't, however it gets to the audience, is fine for me. I mean, this is, and short films, the whole thing with what large short films are doing, and in fact, they were amongst the first platforms to even start doing this on a regular basis. The online environment is probably the best place for short films to come out because there's no other way to put these films together in a theater, you know, because of their length, their running length. So the online environment is probably the best place. And for us, large short films, because of their reputation and what they've been doing, is really sort of a great platform and a great place for this film to be at.
Also, our entire generation is online.
Yeah.
So I think it's a great way to release a film. Like in the West, you have films, you know, some are released as home DVDs, some are released online, some are released in theaters. I think we should also have that kind of system. So it'll give people more space and freedom to make the kind of films that they want to make. And then we don't get stuck with what is in trend, what is not in trend, will somebody back us, will they not. We can just be free and make what we want to make, and especially like brains like Akshat's, which are fully crazy. Then he can, like, he has the freedom and nobody's going to curb him and say ki ye mat karo, nahi ye karoge to audience nahi aayegi, nahi ye gana dalna padega. You can just have fun. And I think that is the whole thing about the creative process, is to actually go with your instinct and to go with what you want to do. I think that's the most honest way of storytelling. So if that can come back, and it is coming back, and there are a lot of amazing storytellers. So if we have more patronage and we have more ways to bring stuff like that out, I think we'll just be a happy audience. I'll be a happy audience. I'll be a happy actor also.
Okay, apart from this, what else is there in the pipeline from your end?
For me? I'm currently shooting Mani Ratnam Sir's film, which is, I think, a dream come true for me. I think it's a dream come true for any actor. So we're in the middle of that. I'm not going to tell you too much about it because we're still working on it. And then I have Sudhir Sir's film, which is ready, and hopefully that should release soon and not get stuck with the kinds of things that happen with films. So I really hope that releases soon because he's an amazing filmmaker too.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
I hope you got something with me looking in the right direction.
No, not at all.
Yeah? Okay.
We'll kill the editor.
I need some lines for the photo shoot when the entire thing is there.
Yeah. So you don't want the others also?
Let them finish with the video, then we'll have the photo shoot with the entire
right.
thing.
Okay.
Yes.
Tell us if you can throw some light on that.
I can't really talk about that project just yet. We are finishing up. I'm actually getting back to shooting with Saif from day after. So we have about a week of work left. And once that is done, we get into post, and the film will release sometime next year, first half next year.
Okay.
It's too early to talk about it. It's a mix of genres. So it's a dark comedy, it's a drama, it's a love story with elements of action in it. So I don't want to sort of give away anything because I can't yet. There will be some materials, there are some teasers coming out soon, so you'll get a sense of what it is.
Saif was always your first choice, you know. I mean, do you think if it in that so-called character, as he's talking about?
Absolutely. In fact, the weird thing is, and when Saif finally came on board, I'd actually written it with Saif in mind, and then we were trying to track him down. And of course, it doesn't happen. You write, you message a star, and you don't hear back. And when I sent him a text, I actually got to meet him exactly almost 2 years later. Once the script had got to him, he read it, he loved it and wanted to do it. And I showed him that text. And he said, I said, look, 2 years ago I wrote to you and I didn't hear from you, and here we are, and you're doing this. So things just happen when they're meant to happen. And it was fantastic to sort of really finally get him. It's not just potential, he's demonstrated that he's a great actor. It's not, so he is a fantastic actor. I mean, his thinking, his comic timing, his thought process in terms of getting into character is phenomenal. And when you're on the outside and when you're looking at actors, you never really get a sense of it. But when you're in a situation where you're working with them, when you have other actors working with them together, then you actually really begin to see their process, their intelligence as actors. So it's been a fantastic experience. It's a revelation.
Can we shoot Sidharan Negative? Huh? He hurt himself.
I can't answer that.
Okay. Thank you so much, Akshat.
Thank you.
Is there a song?
No.
One. अच्छा कुछ तो है
बैकग्राउंड में
वो डांस कर रही है हमें
चलो रो नहीं सकता सर आप तो रेडी हैं तो
बिल्कुल रेडी सर
रो ये रुकना
ओके अक्षय दीवान आप दोनों से इस फिल्म के बारे में सबसे पहले तो जानना चाहेंगे कि कैसा रहा एक्सपीरियंस ममास बॉय का
ममास बॉय बड़ा मतलब मजा आया शूट करके एक्चुअली कास्ट काफ़ी जानती है एक दूसरे को
सब जानते हैं एक दूसरे को सब दोस्त हैं पहले से तो बहुत मज़ा आया साथ में सबको काम करने में एकदम मतलब जैसे धमाल सा हो गया था कि हम सब पुराने दोस्त हैं तो एक साथ में काम करने का जो मौका मिला बहुत ही मज़ेदार था
वैसे भाइयों का कैरेक्टर निभाना है तो उसमें मज़ा आया काफ़ी हंसी मज़ा काफ़ी चीज़ें हुई सेट पे किसी ने लाइन छोड़ दी तो किसी ने कुछ हंस दिया तो किसी ने कुछ बोल दिया तो काफ़ी मज़ा आया
तो ये जो ममास बॉय है आप दोनों ही बने
करण भी था ना लेकिन करण ने छोड़ दिया था कुछ वो दूसरे शिफ्ट कर दिया था उसने कुछ दूसरी साइड पे एट यंग एज लाइक नकुलन साइड बैटिंग पर दिया साइड
करेक्ट करेक्ट बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग कहानी थी इन पांच भाइयों की तो वो उस पर एक सॉर्ट ऑफ कॉमिक It's not like a spoof or a parody of that, but it's using that story in mythology as a sort of comedic allegory, like an allegory, you know, it's like an allegory.
Yeah, it's an interesting perspective also on that story. Because Mahabharata has a lot of things that हमने काफी सोचा है बचपन में पढ़ते वक्त या सुनते वक्त कि ये कैसे हुआ होगा, but actually to exploit that and do a film on that is quite cool.
क्योंकि हमने डायरेक्टर से बात की उन्होंने कहा कि मैथोलॉजी में ये जो है कि बांट लो
जी
आप उसके खिलाफ है तो यहाँ पर इस फिल्म में आप लोग क्या करने वाले हैं
वो तो आपको देखना पड़ेगा कि हम क्या करते कैसे रिएक्ट करते हैं।
जैसे हम बोल रहे थे कि जो पांचों भाइयों हैं उनके जो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स और जो इस आई थिंक इस केस में उनके शायद सेक्सुअल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स और जो सब थे पांचों भाइयों की वो थोड़ा सा एक्सप्लोर कर रहे हैं उसको द्रौपदी को लेकर। तो ऐसे उसमें भी बहुत ऐसे हंसी मजाक कॉमेडी भी है उसमें और उसमें एक इंटरेस्टिंग सी एलिगोरिकल एस्पेक्ट भी है जो जो बहुत जिस विच इज एक्चुअली एन इंटरेस्टिंग टेक ऑन द महाभारत। That's the beauty of it.
But होता क्या है हम कैसे रिएक्ट करते हैं उसके लिए आपको देखना पड़ेगा।
जी वो तो हाँ
अच्छा, तो राज तो वही है।
अच्छा आप लोग क्या आप क्या बने हैं और आप मतलब ये तो
मैं और जिम सर हम दोनों भाई नकुल और सहदेव भाइयों बने हैं। तो इसमें हमने मैं बताऊं कि नहीं बताऊं कि क्या थोड़ा सा तो मैं तो इसमें हम थोड़ा सा ऐसे जैसे स्लाइटली होमोसेक्सुअल टाइप के कैरेक्टर्स हैं और उसमें स्लाइटली मतलब ऑन द सरफेस नहीं है। देखो अभी ये प्रोटेस्ट
आ गया मत बोलो मेरे बारे में। नहीं मैं युधिष्ठिर का कैरेक्टर निभा रहा हूँ तो बट हमने एक दूसरा एंगल दिया है उसको युधिष्ठिर को मतलब वो गैम्बल काफ़ी करते थे हम सबको पता है लेकिन इसमें सिगरेट पीते हैं दारू पीते हैं थोड़ा हल्का सा वुमेनाइजर भी है तो हमने थोड़ा उसमें कलर ऐड किया है जो एक्चुअली युधिष्ठिर के कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स थे हमने थोड़ा इसको एग्जैजरेट किया है।
एग्जैक्टली क्योंकि युधिष्ठिर एक्चुअली बहुत ही सीधा साधा था ना सबसे एकदम स्क्वायर था वो ही वाज द मोस्ट वो कभी झूठ
नहीं बोलता था
और एनी वॉशर था मां की वजह से
रिश्ता था उनका कुछ गहरा था
वही तो उसमें भी वो बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग सा एक रिलेशन
एंगल रखा
युधिष्ठिर और द्रौपदी का वो बहुत आप देखिएगा वो बहुत मजेदार है
क्योंकि ये फिल्म ऑनलाइन रिएक्ट होने वाली है तो इस ऑनलाइन को ऑनलाइन मीडिया को लेकर कितने एक्साइटेड हैं आप लोग क्योंकि हमने डायरेक्टर से बात की अदिति से बात की उन्होंने कहा कि ऑनलाइन पे हर कोई होता
बहुत बहुत फ्यूचर फ्यूचर तो यही है मुझे लगता है
बहुत बढ़िया प्लेटफॉर्म है
बहुत बढ़िया
को देखने को मिलता है अपने घरों पर थिएटर पे भी जाने की जरूरत नहीं है
आप बाथरूम में बैठे तो आप टैबलेट खोल के देख सकते हो आप गाड़ी में हो ट्रैफिक में आप देख सकते हो तो मुझे लगता है ये फ्यूचर है
जी
और काफी लोग इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं इसमें
जी
एवरी स्टूडियोस
बहुत लोग बिल्कुल ये बहुत ही एक प्रैक्टिकल फॉर मीडियम है जिससे इंफॉर्मेशन या कंटेंट या जो भी है पहुंचा जाता है
और मुझे लगता है फिल्में भी इसके वजह से बेहतर होने वाली है बिकॉज जब कंपटीशन बढ़ता जाएगा तो जो आप वेब सीरीज पे देख रहे हो अगर वो ज्यादा अच्छा है फिर आपको फिल्में भी बेहतर होनी चाहिए नहीं तो आप गाड़ी में बैठ करके आप नहीं जाओगे ना थिएटर ₹1000 आपको खर्चा करना पड़ता है पॉपकॉर्न ये वो पूरी फैमिली को आप लेकर के जाते हो मुझे लगता है थोड़ा इंप्रूव होगा सिनेमा इसकी वजह से।
अच्छा मिलती कि इसको द्रौपदी आईडब्ल्यू
क्योंकि हां इसमें
ये तो देखना पड़ेगा पता करने के लिए
भाई आपको महाभारत याद है महाभारत आप ध्यान में रखिए
महाभारत में लेकिन आपको देखना पड़ेगा उसको वो देखना करने के लिए देखना पड़ेगा
या
ओके
थैंक यू सो मच थैंक यू
थैंक यू थैंक यू
Come on, Akshat Verma, the talented director, beautiful, gorgeous Aditi, Akshay, Vivan, Isha Chopra, Jim, Amol, and Tina Singh. Before we proceed further, can we have the photo op? Can we have a photo op? Yes, picture together. Let's capture some beautiful memories.
We need one more chair.
Thank you. Thank you. I request everyone, please be seated. Please be seated. That's really nice. So can you tell us something about the movie?
It's such a short film that if I tell you about it, there'll be nothing left to watch it. it's a film about, it's, you know, most films come from the question of what if. You know, when things are a certain way, you always wonder, what if there was a different way? And for me, this film comes out of the story of the Mahabharata, which I'd heard as a child all through. But I always wondered, the story of, you know, how Arjun goes out and he wins Draupadi in this contest, and he comes back home, and his mother says, whatever it is you've got, just share with your brothers. and they go along with it. And that never really worked for me. How can you bring a girl home and somebody says, share her, and you're like, okay. I imagine the conversation in the Pandav household was a little different from what we've been told it. So this is what that story is about. I mean, how the mother said something, and then the whole push and pull, the politics, the back and forth of what really went on behind the scenes, not only from the side of the brothers, but also the biggest manipulator in this actually is Draupadi, who's like, okay, this seems like a bad thing, but maybe it's not it. Five husbands could be, for the price of one, is a really good idea. So it's usually the other way around, but I'm all for women power. So that's what this film is about.
Thank you so much, sir, for your answer. It's time to hear from beautiful, gorgeous, you know, no words to describe her beauty, versatile. Okay.
Please.
Ma'am, can you just tell us about
your... Let a girl also be talented.
Yes, of course, you're very talented.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Can you just tell us about your role and your overall experience while working on this movie?
I don't want to get into like a discussion about my part, because I think this film is really just fun. And Akshat has said as much as needed to be said. It's also like a 15-minute film, so I don't think we can get into intellectualizing it too much. But it's a really, really fun film. It's a fun script. The characters are funny. They've been sort of turned on their heads. Not quite, actually, because as he said, if you actually read that story, you can have a parallel conversation and you can hear a parallel conversation that all these characters are having. For example, Draupadi is probably saying, oh, damn, five husbands, that's not fair. But she's actually probably saying, shit, that's a lot of fun. One will take me shopping. One will possibly have an intellectual conversation with me. One will take me to the gym or whatever it is. So I think that could be like fun, variety. So it's turning these characters on their heads. Versatility, yes.
Versatile. Yes.
The whole quest for versatility. So maybe that's what attracted me to it as well, because I'm constantly saying, versatile, versatile, not only luminous, please. So anyway, so I always wanted to work with Akshat because I've seen his work and fallen over many times laughing my head off. I was going to use another word there. This is a family show. So I was really happy to be here, and amazing actors from Jim to Akshay, who I've worked with. God, Akshat, Akshay is a bit confusing. To Isha, who's actually a friend of mine, Tina, Amol and Vivana. Amol is looking different, huh? So it's a bit difficult to recognize him. Yeah, literally. It's like three Arjuns have come out of him. But yeah, it was really fun. So I'm going to just leave it at that and let you watch the film.
Oh, thank you so much. Can we offer her also? Come on. Thank you.
You don't have to clap for that.
Because she's versatile. Okay, Akshay sir, can you tell us any memorable incident during shooting?
Memorable incident during shoot.
Hey, I forgot to say, oh my God, I'm so sorry I snatched the mic from you, because this is really important. Nina Gupta, who was just insane on set.
And
you know, everybody asked, how did you prepare for this part? All my preparation was trying not to laugh when she was speaking on set, because she is hilarious. She's amazing.
That's true. Memorable incident from shoot. Well, as everybody here knows, Akshat is a really...
I got bit by a dog.
No. Actually, I was going to say that story you asked. That actually was part of my story. Now that he took that way, yeah, it was. But anyway, so now a different story. So Akshat did get bit by a dog on a recce. I think that's quite interesting. So we all know he's a funny guy. So his writing is really hilarious. So when you're playing these dialogues as actors, you don't actually have to do a whole lot but say the dialogue. And we have this final sequence at the end where we're all eating. It's dinner scene together. And... So I'm not going long on it, okay? So basically, it's this last kind of meal we're having where we're talking about something very specific. And every actor just, like, it was so funny. I mean, Jim had this one line that he was stuck on, and it was hilarious. And we wouldn't let him do it, even when he would get it. It was the way he was saying it, all of it. I remember Anuradha's lines as well. You know, he's talking about his, you know, protein and carbs and all. It's just hilarious stuff. So we could never actually get through it. And I think the shoot kept going, and Vivan had to take a flight because Vivan was shooting like a double shift. From Delhi, he had flown in just to shoot. So you could just see like Vivan sinking, like, when is this going to finish? How are we going to get out of here?
And he was actually sick the second day.
So, yeah. And I think that that dinner sequence kind of sums up our, well, at least my experience on this film. It was a lot of fun. There's some great actors, some really good talent. So thanks to Royal Stag. And yeah, that's it.
Next. And beautiful too. Okay, can you share the best part while working in this movie?
Well, I had a great time because I had to shoot at La Senza. So my whole scene consisted of taking Draupadi shopping, lingerie shopping. And I never ever thought that I would be sitting in Mahabharat attire going and shopping for thongs or, you know, something like that. So that was kind of hilarious. And I thought it was great because we're friends and we kind of like have these conversations sometimes. And we're very versatile. We do. So it was a great time. It was, and it's funny to think about it because I feel like today girls kind of suffer for this, right? Like we're spoiled for choice all the time. And when we get that, we get confused.
Yes. Yes, can you tell us now something about the movie?
Well, I shot for only one day, and my sequence was in a gym, and it was really interesting because I was wearing like sports shoes and sports gear with like Mahabharat jewelry, and so it was very exciting. And also Arunade, who's playing my boyfriend, he has some really interesting dialogues, so it was really hilarious. You have to see the film to see it. And I had a great time. I only had one day of shoot, but I think it was super, super fun. Akshat is a great director. I think I've seen his films before. So when I was called, they said it's just a one-day role, but I was like, yeah, if Akshat's making it, I'll do it. Wow, so yeah. And also since the media is here, everyone's here, I'm just going to digress a little bit and just say my first film just released this Friday. Please go watch it. It's called Akira. Yeah. I debut in it. Sorry to take this opportunity to like.
A quick aside for Tina. Tina was playing a character called Hidimba, who in Mahabharata is Bhim's girlfriend / wife. And when my casting director punched me, said, "Hey, this is the option I have." I said, "If there is one person in the universe who doesn't look like a Hidimba, it's Tina, because you said this is Hidimba. You don't put those two together." So we're like, "Yes, she must be Hidimba." Yeah. So that. Hidimba / Tina. Please watch Akira for her.
Yes.
One thing that I remember, like a funny thing, conversation I had with Akshat before we shot the film was, I read the script, he sent me the script, he said, "Dekho, pasand aaye." Mujhe bahut pasand aaye, I want to do it. And he said, "Yeah, so we'll shoot it, like the lingo is very today, although we're doing a Mahabharat scene, the lingo is very today, but he said, we'll wear those costumes. I'll make you wear the mukut, I'll make you wear those covers." I thought he was joking. So I thought, "Nay, obviously we'll wear today's costume, because we're talking in today's language." But then finally I realized when I went for the costume trial that actually those costumes, I was a little conscious about showing off my body.
Okay.
But he made me feel comfortable.
That's the kind of filmmaker I am.
Yeah. So I worked out for a day before I shot for the film. Just to be in shape.
I didn't stop working out. I've disappeared.
The
trauma. Yes.
I just want to make sure next time that happens, that surprise comes along, I am prepared for it. So now I am. So next time we do this, I am prepared for the costumes.
So you are completely trained. Thank you for your answer. It's time to hear from you.
All of us were sucking in our tummies like that on the day of the shoot. You all walking around like this. So that, it was great fun. It was amazing, amazing fun. And I think everyone in my generation is a huge fan of Akshat. Because, you know, we all, like, yeah, in Delhi Belly, after Delhi Belly came out, we were like, "Dude, this guy is like the Guy Ritchie of India, man." We were all so proud of, like, we really, everyone is a huge, my entire generation loves him, like, worships him. He's awesome. He was great fun to work with, and the whole bunch of people, they was like, it was amazing. Everybody's friends, everybody knows each other from Pele, so it was just great fun. The camaraderie and all between everyone was just beautiful. It was great fun.
Yes, sir, now? Jim, sir?
Huh?
Can you say something about the movie?
You have a question?
Yes, can you talk us something about the movie?
Okay. I don't know about the movie that much. I just know my experience of reading the script.
And I love reading his scripts because it's so clear. There no character description is needed. The way the character talks is the way the character is. And I love that. There's no extra bullshit scene descriptions. There's no extra nonsense. There's no fluff. You read it like how you see it, and I love that. Because then I can start having ideas. Then I can start doing things. I don't have to be busy minusing things to understand how to play something. You know, he doesn't put in brackets laughing or disgruntled or disappointed. You know what I mean? He leaves that up to me. And the line itself has the key for how to play it. I love that. That's all I can say.
Thank you, everyone, for your answers. Does the media have any questions? As the floor is now open for Q&A. Anyone?
Thank you.
Now, what took you so long coming with this short film?
Akshat. He took a long time to write it. But we are making another film. We are shooting right now, so that should be out as well very soon, next year, early next year. And yeah, he took very long to write a short film. So that was it.
Because it's not a large short film.
It's a large short film, yeah. No.
Anybody can come out and say, boss, this is something against Mahabharata, or this is something against Ramayana, you know, this happened. But filmmakers are always soft-targeted people.
I mean, we're making the film for the internet. I'm hoping the people who watch it will not take it literally. It's for fun, it's entertainment, and I guess that's what freedom of speech is about. You should be able to make what you want to make. And whoever wants to watch it will watch it. You have the freedom to watch it or not watch it, basically. That's why we've made it for the internet. So we've made it for the internet so that whoever wants to watch it will watch it, and there'll be no censor stuff there.
Yeah. And I hope that people will learn.
Yeah, people should just like have fun with it. It's not supposed to be. It's a movie. It's a short, fun film. Yeah. Thank you.
Anyone else?
Controversies are good for films anyway.
Akshay Oberoi said that.
Anyone else?
Akshat, wapis main shayad mera main might be I'm repeating myself, you know, star cast ki agar main baat karu na ekdam alag tarah ki star cast hai, you know, Meena Gupta is sab maujood nahi hai, unhe maujood nahi hai. Casting kya zehen mein rakhe kariye na Aditi, it was always there in your mind, you know, when you started working on the story.
See, I
Aditi to play this or Nakul Zaidev will be played by Vivan or somebody.
No, so you know, as you watch people and their work, and you sort of, at least I do, I keep filing away people. I have a list of people I desperately want to work with, so whenever there's a chance, I want to be able to, and the thing of throwing different actors together in an unexpected way is what really makes things pop. So my thing with Panchmi, our casting director, was like, these are the people I have in mind. This is my ideal list. Do you think we can pull this together? And she put it together. Because, and I'm going to say this, I mean, I think the thing with our industry is that we have some incredible actors here. The only place where we let our actors down actually is in the quality of the writing and the direction. Our technical talent is fantastic, our acting talent is fantastic. If we can also begin to put them together in stories that work in a certain way, to a certain level, to a certain quality, I think we can do incredible work. So my intention is to just keep going down my list and work with all the people I want to work with over and over again, because great actors make it, I mean, take work to a whole other level. They make it a joy. So it then becomes, instead of fighting the process, they suddenly take the material somewhere else where it needs to go, and then that's when it really begins to fly. And thankfully, that's what happened, at least for me, on this process.
Okay, how Jim came on board?
we called him and he said, okay. So of course, when you're casting, when you know casting directors already know of people, actors who are working. He's very active in theater. He has a reputation, and he's only breaking through now to the larger audience. But for everybody else in the industry, people know, they're very, very aware of him. So the fact, I mean, that's the thing. Actors begin to break to the outside audience later, but otherwise, people who know are keeping tabs on talented people. It's not it's not like you can hide them. Their work sort of speaks for themselves, and people are aware of it.
You can say that, I can't say that. You know, I think our entire generation, and I think everybody, is on the internet 24/7, literally. Like sometimes, hum jab international flight leke aate hain, and you tweet something, you know, at 3 in the morning, you get replies, and many replies from people in this country. So there are people on the internet all the time. Okay, I get replies. Whatever, but it happens. So it is a fully booming a medium to reach out to people, and it is also the kind of medium where you can be as creative and as crazy as you want to be, and I think that is amazing for the creative process, because otherwise, you know, itni badhaein hoti hain ki ye mat karo, aise mat karo, us actor ko lo, iska abhi time acha chal raha hai, iske stars acche hain, ye astrologically this one matches with this one, all this happens. And I'm not making fun of that. I mean, each to his own, that's fine. But for people who just want to tell a fun story or want to reach out to certain people or have something that has been playing in their mind for a long time, whatever, this is a great way to do it. And I think that the bottom line of cinema, a book, any kind of communication is that if your communication is engaging, then people are going to watch. So if you have a good script, if you have good actors, if you have a good director, then people are going to watch it. Not if you have an actor whose last film did 150 crores, not if you have a director whose last film did 150, it's not, I mean, chota mo badi baat, I'm still newish in the industry, so it sounds wrong when I say this, but I truly believe that. I have that conviction that our country, there is nothing stopping us. We have the most insane talent. We have everything over here. What stops us is lack of conviction in ourselves. We always wait for somebody else to say very good, and then we do it. But we can do it ourselves without anything. And I think people like Seagram's Royal Stag, Barrel Select, large short films, Ashi, Akshat, and a lot of us actors present over here, we want to do work like that, and this gives us that opportunity. And I think audiences see that. Audiences see ki, acha, inko sachi mein ye kahani batani thi, to hume, aur fir hume dekhni hai. So they get drawn to content like that. So I think it's an instinctive thing. I can't say ki haan zarur dekhenge kyunki mujhe maza aaya banake, but I hope dekhenge kyunki fun kahani hai. It's as simple as that. I'll still get the replies, hope.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. I'm sure we all are eagerly waiting to, you know, watch this movie. Yes, I request all my star cast, my dignitaries, please be seated in the front row.